just barely over the 3,000 pound mark, we have a beautifully well-kept one owner, locally owned and traded Jayco 17 RB Hummingbird coming in here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Basically, the family just grew. They needed something with bunks that was a little bit bigger and swapped her out for a tiny Winnebago. She is in truly the kind of condition that is deserving of the phrase like new. This is a small bodied, sort of specialized product that just has a dynamite sort of look to it. Now with the slide closed, you gotta do a little bit of a sideways travel trailer two-step, which is one of my favorite dances if you pay attention to a lot of our videos. But you can get through here. So without opening the slide, you can get to all the storage and everything. I guess it doesn't technically need the slide, you're just really gonna want it when you get to your destination. But this thing's small enough, because it's only a 6.5 foot wide body, even if you open up the slide, you're still contained within a conventional parking space. So even at a travel stop, you can still open the slide and use everything. And good gravy, is this thing well kept? It is clean, the cabinetry's not scuffed up, it doesn't smell, well it does smell, it smells clean. Like you can smell that they actually kept this thing clean. I mean, even my shoes, that's the sound rubber makes when it grabs like a clean linoleum floor. You know, I mean, this is like they had this thing Swiffered up. We are ventless, carpetless, easy cleaning. You have a full-size roof air conditioner. You also have a full-size interior height. It's a 6'6" interior, which is something that not all little campers have been known to do. All the original entertainment and everything is present and accounted for. The TV's on a swing arm so we can face over here toward the dinette. And I love the door side viewing windows that we have here. Cabinetry is another area where little campers like this will sometimes cut corners. Not all of them, but some do. And they did not do that here. You've got the same hardwood cabinet door frames, metal hold backs, and pocket screwed cabinetry that you have in something like a Jayco North Point all the way down here in this little critter. Flipping us around the other way, again, love that door side window, and you do have a pleated shade there for privacy. Primarily a singles or couples camper, but you've got the little dinette you could fold down if need be, and there is a power outlet down there. I don't know if you can see it, but hiding kind of right between those two posts against that far dinette bench. You do have a set of outlets there. Now, little detail things too, like you see that extra drawer below the fridge? That's just the little kind of Hummingbird stuff that's helped differentiate them over the years. That's a convection microwave, by the way. It's easy to miss since I don't have that open. And that sink area, the countertop behind it is deceptively deep. They also put a set of power outlets back there, so you've got a great little kind of appliance corner. Now, one more thing before we hop into the bathroom. If you look at that partition wall, there's this black thing sticking out. This camper includes its own outdoor picnic table, and it's got a cool little space to store it right here. So you have a 2 foot by 4 foot resin bodied outdoor picnic table that if you want to leave it outside and it rains, ain't ever gonna hurt this thing. This is the Hummingbird that has the full shower area, the full bathroom here, and I believe it's probably one of the reasons why it very quickly became their most popular Hummingbird. Around the corner here, we also have a nice storage compartment, but I like that it's mirrored to give you that extra sense of space in here. Good legroom in front of the toilet is also something else I look for in a camper, because I've got long legs, and again, that's legit storage. Due to its proximity to the kitchen, I suppose you could use it sort of like a pantry, but I mean, you can pack a lot of towels in here, you know, toiletries, bath soaps, etc. You get the idea. One of the things that's really made these successful over the couple seasons they've been out, because this was about the first year these were built, is the narrow body nature of this thing. This is only a 6.5 foot wide body, which is extra narrow even in comparison to a lot of narrow body campers. Now the idea there is it's easier to see around. You know, you're not as intimidated by it being behind a small vehicle or even a big vehicle if you're not a towing expert or anything like that. Also, since the wheels stand outside of the RV's body, that gives this thing some tremendous towing stability. Now, I see the little sort of hook bill on the front of that thing there. It sort of looks like a pill with a little notch taken out of it. That's an extra little thing that Jayco did. They extended the body of it just slightly with that notch, and what that allowed them to do was shift the bed forward 6 inches. So this basically has a 6-inch wider living area than other similar types of campers. Another cool thing on these, absolutely no rubberized roofing to have to maintain. Now, there's still some roof seals that you need to keep track of, and that's true of, you know, any RV. But the fact is, it's front-to-back fiberglass, side-to-side fiberglass. Yeah, there's just less to have to monkey with. All LED tail and marker lights. This also has, and you saw that indoor-outdoor picnic table we talked about slotted inside. So if you want to pop something under that awning there, it has that outside TV hookup station. You know, you could have yourself a little outside entertainment. And the bumper does have a gas grill quick connect, so you are set and ready there. But I mean, even look at the condition of the tire. We didn't detail this. This is not cleaned. This is exactly how the folks brought it to us. They had this thing all shined up, all prettied up and gussied up for the big ball, basically. So it looks, I mean, you know, the power jack at it, we got the power awning, it's got the simple side solar prep. She is sharp. It is dressed and pressed and ready to roll, guys. If you're looking for your first little couples camper, you got a small vehicle, or you just don't want to tow something big and scary, give us a call. We got a great one for you here, especially good for first timers because you're not inheriting someone else's problems. And I mean, this would be an awesome way to spend less money to get into a nice RV, and it's still young enough, it could probably qualify for same as new finance pending approval. And those are all good qualities. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.